Something came from Baltimore. Hey guys, welcome to Something Came From Baltimore. I am your host, Tom Gouker. Remember that Something Came From Baltimore is a jazz, blues, and R&B podcast and radio show, and it's not really about Baltimore, but today it is. It's the Orioles, and not the Baltimore baseball team or the Birds or anything like that. It is the Orioles. Were an American R&B group of the late 1940s and early 1950s, one of the earliest such vocal groups who established the basic pattern of doo-wop sound. The Orioles are generally acknowledged as an R&B group first vocal group. Baltimore natives, they blend rhythm with group harmonies, dubbing themselves after Maryland State Bird. The Orioles started the trend of bird groups, the Cardinals, the Crows, the Flamingos, the Larks, the Penguins, and the Ravens, etc. The original members is Sonny Till as lead tenor, Alexander Sharp as high tenor, George Nelson as baritone, Johnny Reed is the bass vocalist and double bass, and Tommy Gaithers the third is guitar.
You saw me crying in the chapel. The tears I shed were tears of joy. I know the meaning of contentment. I am happy with the just a plain and simple chapel where all good people go to pray. I prayed the Lord that I'll grow strong as I live from day to day.
This interview, you're going to hear songs from the Orioles, and we will have the opportunity to really tap into some of their history, because we have Marv Goldberg on the line today via Zoom, and he is a true pioneer of documenting R&B music. His specialty is the 1940s and 1950s. So we are going to talk to him a little more about the Orioles and listen to some of the tracks. Before we get into the Orioles, I just want to thank you very much. I see my future in you. I'm a big music fan. I've been doing disc jockeying for a long time, and I had a radio show, and radio has crumbled, and now I do this podcast. I've been doing it for 5 to 6 years. I'm in my own room now. We don't do studios. Your passion level is hard to explain to people, because it's a part of you. It's a part of your DNA. I respect you so much, because I can't explain to people how much I love music and why I love it. And I know for a fact that you are someone who is the same person.
Absolutely.
So,
absolutely. Yeah. Thank you.
We have the Orioles. That is, to me, they're such a blip on our current history, but they had such a stamp at the time. They were very successful at the time.
Extremely successful, yes.
Yeah. Do you remember, like, when they came out, or what they were like, or
if you're talking about the Orioles, Of course, I do not remember them because I was a little kid at the time. I wasn't listening to that, and they did not play it on any station that my parents listened to. But they made an incredible splash in the music industry. What happened was that Sonny Till, who was their lead singer, he sang romantic ballads. Now, as far as I'm concerned, he didn't have that great a voice, but they say that he made love to the microphone. That's the phrase they use. And the girls in the audience went crazy for it. The boys in the audience saw how crazy the girls were going for it. And any of them who could sing said, I want to do that. Mm-hmm. And hundreds of groups were launched because of the Orioles. Most of them were not successful, of course, but they were, and they were there. And I guess the most successful Black group before that was the Ink Spots, but very few singers could emulate the high-pitched voice of their lead singer, Bill Kenny. It was easier to sound like Sonny Till than to sound like Bill Kenny.
I dream of you, my heart wanders all the day, but I miss you most of all at night, dear heart, when darkness falls and I walk along the street, I every girl I meet, hoping it's you. I know.
Yeah, you're right. And it's interesting that you're 100% correct. It was the charisma and charm and the presentation that helped that band elevate. I mean, the songs are good. He was dynamic in his own right. Like, that's was a figure. And that's kind of what pop music is now. It doesn't matter how you sound. You just gotta look good.
Like I Only Have Eyes For You, which was led by Junior Denby. I guess it's mostly because I love the song itself.
Mm-hmm. It's a great song.
Yeah. What I would say about the Orioles is I was really, really lucky because Sonny Till, the lead singer, was the first person I ever interviewed. Okay. And I interviewed him in person, and I was lucky because his idol was Nat King Cole, who taught him a saying, it's nice to be nice. And Sonny was very gracious to me over years, all the questions I asked. And there was a time when I came to him with a list of over 50 questions. And I'm asking him the questions. And for most of them, he said, I don't know. or I don't remember. And then he looked at my face and he saw how crestfallen I was that here this idol of mine doesn't remember anything about his career. And he stopped me and he said, Marv, it was a job. We went to the studio when they told us to go to the studio. We went to an appearance where they told us to go to an appearance. We didn't have any say over it. It was just a job. And that really changed the way I looked at these things. And after that, when I went into an interview with somebody, either on the phone or in person, I would beforehand, I would say to myself, just keep in mind that if somebody asked me what I did 40 years ago, I wouldn't have a clue. I wouldn't remember it. So sure. I couldn't expect them to remember every single thing as long as I felt they were trying to remember. That was the important thing.
What they're saying isn't so, that our love is burning low. If you found somebody new,
you found somebody new,
don't you think I ought to know? Dining at the club alone, I can feel the people stare. Do you think I made of stone?
You think I made of stone?
Don't you think I ought to know? You know, darling, I've always had such faith in you and the things we have done.
So, like I said, I was lucky Sonny Too was the first interview I did.
It's such a magical experience, the fact that he didn't remember. Do you feel that that was interesting? Like, he's like, I don't even remember this.
Like, yeah. Well, is it transformative experience for me?
Yeah.
I don't know what he had encountered before I started. This was, again, during this oldies craze of the 60s. I don't know how much anybody ever bothered to ask him about his career before that. You know, I might have been the first one to try to dig into it. I really have no idea.
Just time has passed. I think a lot of people who actually live in Baltimore wouldn't even remember that there was a group called the Orioles. There's some people who remember it and some people wouldn't.
That's true. I'm sure most people, let's say under 40, wouldn't know that there was a singing group called the Orioles.
Well, even in my research, I was surprised that I knew all these songs. I was like, wow. Like, they had hits.
They had hits. One of the things I dreamed up in all my writing was there were five group lead singers you had to know in order to sing, to understand vocal groups. One of them was Bill Kenny from the Ink Spots. One of them was Sonny Till from the Orioles. One of them was Jimmy Ricks from the Ravens. You had to know him because that's what all bass singers had to sound like. One of them was Clyde McFatter from the Dominoes and the Drifters, because his was the voice that supplanted Sonny Till's. Well, every singer wanted to sound like him, and an awful lot could. And the last one was Frankie Lyman from the Teenagers. Mm-hmm. His voice launched hundreds and hundreds of incredibly inferior groups.
Only moody over you, honey.
Honey,
when you're near, it's sunny.
Sunny,
though you.
I need to squeeze in booty over you. Oh, won't you please come back? Oh, won't you please come back?
I don't have any more questions, but I do thank you for talking to me and having
a conversation. No problem. Love to be here, Tom. Thank you very much for having me.
See, rider, look what you have done. Love made me love you. Now your man has come. Well, you made me love you. Now your man has come. See, rider, where did you stay last night? Lord, shoes ain't buttoned, clothes don't fit you right. Come home till the sun was shining bright.
Thank you for the Orioles for creating so many hits through those years. Information on the group is listed in our show notes. Don't forget to subscribe to the show because Something Came From Baltimore is now on 35 different platforms and counting. The show's over and have a great day.
Something came from Baltimore. Something came from Baltimore.